Okay, now we are seeing this problem for loop on HackerRank. So this problem statement is pretty easy. We just have to take in A and B as our input, and after that we just have to start a for loop with A and B included, because there are square brackets, so we'll include A and B. If there were round brackets, then we wouldn't include A and B. So if there are square brackets, we will obviously include A and B. After that, if n is from 1 to 9, we'll have to print the English representation, that is 1, 2 in English and in lower cases. So if you try to solve it by using if condition, then you will have to make 9 conditions for 1, 2, 3 up to 9. You'll have to type a lot, and we can't type a lot, it's too much work for us. So instead of that, we can use arrays. I'll show it to you all. And after that, if n is greater than 9, we just have to print out if it is even or odd, that's all. So first of all, let us take sample input and we'll try to code it now. So first of all, I have to take a and b as input. So simply I'll start a variable a and b. After that, I just have to use cin. I have to take A and B. After that, I have to start a loop. So, instead of that, I'll just start an array. That array will be of strings. I'm making this array for the English representation, that is 1, 2, and all. That's why. So, string array, and it will contain, I guess, 10 elements. Yeah. Why 10? Because see, when I write this array, I'll start from 0, because always indexing starts from 0. So, I'll write 0. Then 1 and so on up to 9. So hold on, I'll just decrease the size. Yeah, so what we did over here, we started a string array from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 up to 9. Okay, I'll just zoom in now. So see, what will happen if I call in AR of 1, then it will print out 1. Actually, if I call C out, so it will print out 1. If I call AR of 4, then it will print out 4. And 0th index is not important because we don't have to do anything for 0. They have to hold from 1. So I can write anything over here. That's not important. And after that, for 1 and all, we got it. So after that, I just have to use if conditions. So if I'll have to write if I is from, instead of, I have to start a loop first. Sorry. So I'll just start a loop for I equals to, now they have to hold to range I from A to B, and A and B are included. So I'll start I from A simply, and I will go up to B less than and equal to B, because B is included as I discussed, and then simply I plus plus. So this is our for loop. Instead of that we'll use if now. So if I let I, when I is less than or equal to 9, because they have told if it is less than or equal to 9, then we have to use this array. We have to basically print out the English representation. So what I have to do is, I'll simply use cout, okay, and I'll simply write AR of I, and I'll end the line. So what happened over here is, when I will be 1, it will see, yeah, I is 1, this will get satisfied, then it will go inside it, so it will print AR of 1, that is this thing. AR of 0 is this thing, AR of 1 is this thing, then AR is 4, it will print out AR of 4, that is this 4. So we got English representation by this. So we skipped many if conditions. And now else. So I used else because if it is not from, sorry, hold on. Yeah, so else because if it is not less than 9, obviously it will be 10, 11 and so on. So I can directly write else, or you can also write else if I is from 9 to whatever. But instead of that, else is nice. So else, what we'll do is, we have to check if the number is even or odd. Yeah. So I'll just write if I modulo 2. So modulo 2 gives us the remainder. Hold on, yeah. Modulo 2 gives us the remainder. So if it is even, then the remainder of I divided by 2 will be 0. So if this is the case, it will be even. So I'll just simply print out even over here. And after that, I'll have to end the line. Yeah. And after that, else. Again, why else? Because if the number is not even, then obviously it is odd. So I'll simply print out else, it is odd. So it is not even, that is, it is odd. Yeah, end line. Yeah, the code looks fine up to now. I'll just let's run it now. Okay, I missed something. I was not clear. Ah, sorry, it will be integer. I code in Python as well, that's why I forget. Yeah, now let's run it. Yeah, I think they have told from 8 to 11, 8, 9, even and odd. But let's check it first. Yeah, for 8 and 11, 8, 9, even odd, 8, 9, even odd, yeah, so it works. So I'll just simply copy this whole code and paste it on HackerRank website so that we can verify all the test cases and all. I'll just submit it directly. Yeah, each and every test case is satisfied, so there's no error. So I think that works. Thank you.